The leadership of the Nigerian Bar Association in Abuja has told state governors there is no let-off in the call for the implementation of Executive Order 10, which entails financial autonomy for state judiciary. The lawyer said this on Monday during a protest march to the National Assembly. CB360's Simisola Adigun reports.
Abuja, the nation's capital. Members of the Nigerian Bar Association are here at the National Assembly to throw their weight behind the judicial workers fighting for autonomy for the judiciary. But the NBA delegation led by the first Vice President John Aipoko Martin was barred from accessing the National Assembly.
They have refused to allow us into the premises of the National Assembly. I find it extremely very shocking. I don't understand why the National Assembly can shut out the body of lawyers in Nigeria. However, I want to pass the message, because we have no other choice but to pass the message. We have been here for more than 1 hour, and we think it's demeaning to keep us outside the gates of the National Assembly for more than 1 hour. We are sending to the governors of all the states in Nigeria, particularly the governors who are lawyers, that you have no right whatsoever to negotiate the provisions of the Constitution.
After a two-hour wait, Deputy Clerk of the National Assembly, Bala Yabani, addressed the NBA delegation.
Don't have any notice of your coming. That was why. And don't worry, after this interaction, there are some of the people that I would blame for not informing me earlier about this your coming. Otherwise, I could have received you very well. Secondly, the leadership of the National Assembly is now on recess. Therefore, they could not receive you. That is why maybe our officers, you know, denied you entry into the foyer. And we, the senior officers, are not on seat at that particular time. Otherwise, there is no way that we cannot grant you access to the foyer.
You told the able vice president that you were my classmate.
Yeah.
Yes, I confirmed that.
Yes.
Right from University of Maiduguri to the Nigerian Law School. And we are happy we have lawyers in the administration of the National Assembly, as well as senators and members of House of Reps. But again, we were pained that we stood outside under the scorching sun for almost 2 hours. For now, the able first vice president has said he has forgiven you, him as a person. Now, as a corporate body, we will work on the NBA leadership to also forgive.
So we are here to register our appreciation to the National Assembly and the federal government for complying. And we want the National Assembly to ensure that there is no negotiation. There's no room for negotiation. What we want is a pure implementation of the provisions of the law.
This thing, we want this particular country to be one so that the Constitution of Federal Republic of Nigeria should be obeyed, and it must be obeyed. The governors cannot be directing us on what to do and all that. Let them wait for us in 2023. We are waiting for them.
The Judiciary Staff Union of Nigeria, JUSUN, had on 6 April shut down courts across the country as they pressed home their demand for state governors to comply with the constitutional provision on the financial autonomy for the judiciary. Simisola Adigun, TV360, Abuja.